Next, the highs and lows of a famous rock group called The Band, led by Canadian guitarist Robbie Robertson. The story is told in a new documentary, and Jeffrey Brown has the story, part of our ongoing arts and culture series, Canvas.
The honor of opening last fall's Toronto International Film Festival went not to a splashy new Hollywood film, but to the documentary Once We're Brothers. And why not? At its heart is Robbie Robertson, a local boy who made it big after first hearing early rock and roll in the 1950s.
When this music came along that was like, that's it. That's the sound. That's the feeling. That's the rebel spirit. Let's go.
At 15, he would join the rockabilly band of Ronnie Hawkins and begin touring all over North America. A few years later, he was playing lead guitar as Bob Dylan went electric.
He opened some doors that we didn't know what was behind those doors before. There was a way he could write about things that nobody wrote about before.
I pulled into Nazareth, just feeling about half-past dead.
Most of all, Robertson was lead guitarist and songwriter for one of rock's most important and beloved bands, called simply The Band. Robertson, Rick Danko, Richard Manuel, Garth Hudson, all Canadian, and Levon Helm, the Arkansas-born singer and drummer. With songs like Up on Cripple Creek and The Wait, The Band brought together disparate influences to make something new. In the documentary, Bruce Springsteen recalls hearing the seminal 1968 album, Music from Big Pink.
There is no band that emphasizes coming together and becoming greater than the sum of their parts than The Band. Simply their name, The Band. That was it.
And when Music from Big Pink came out, people said, what is this?
Yeah.
Where did this come from? Right. This doesn't fit in. This isn't what's happening. And we were like, thank you. Thank you.
Because that's what you wanted to hear.
Our job is not to be what's happening. Our job is to be as honest as we can about this noise that we're making.
It all culminated in 1976 in San Francisco with one of rock's most renowned concerts, The Band's Last Waltz, made into a film by Martin Scorsese and featuring a long list of stars, Eric Clapton, Joni Mitchell, Neil Young, Van Morrison, and many others, capped off by Dylan. It was music that changed its time. But Daniel Rohr, the director of Once We're Brothers and also from Toronto, is just 26. And he says the music has lived on for many in his generation.
I would say that the cool kids know The Band.
The cool kids know The Band.
Yeah, I mean, you know, the music's timeless. Well, when I came to this project, these guys were mythic, larger than life, legendary. You watch The Last Waltz, and they're just the coolest, most incredible guys. They just occupy this mythic space in rock and roll history and cultural history. And I think what really came into focus when I made the film is that these rock and roll idols of mine, these heroes of mine, these guys that I worshipped, they were just like me. You know, they were just like five guys trying to do the best they could, battling their insecurities and their demons amidst very challenging circumstances, trying to navigate success.
The night ain't no more.
The brotherhood didn't last amid drugs, alcohol, depression, squabbles over direction, and resentment by other members of the band of Robertson, who they claim took too much credit, including when it came to collecting songwriting royalties. In a 1983 memoir, Levon Helm wrote bitterly of his former best friend. Helm died in 2012 of throat cancer. Richard Manuel took his own life in 1986. Rick Danko struggled with addiction for years and died in 1999 at age 56. Garth Hudson is the only other surviving band member. Robbie Robertson told his side of the story in his 2016 memoir, Testimony, the basis for Daniel Rohr's new film.
I think it's a bittersweet story. I think it's a bittersweet story because ultimately we're left with this phenomenal body of work, this music that will live on forever. But at the same time, that comes with the acrimony that we spoke to earlier, and that comes with the bitterness and sadness and tragedy.
Now 76, Robertson has written music for many films, often working with Scorsese, including composing the score for The Irishman. And he recently released a new album, Cinematic, his first in 8 years, including songs like Dead End Kid, featuring Irish singer Glenn Hassard, that tells stories from his own life.
You're just a dead-end kid, probably end up in prison.
Each song is like a little movie, and some of them are about, not about who I broke up with, but growing up in Toronto at one time when I was just getting started. And I had these dreams, and I thought, I'm going to do this, and I think I could do that, and oh, it'd be great to go out in the world, and I want to write songs. And people were like, what? Oh, you're going to be disappointed. That's not going to happen.
It did happen for Robbie Robertson, along with much drama and pain along the way. The film Once Were Brothers, Robbie Robertson and the Band, is now showing around the country. For the PBS NewsHour, I'm Jeffrey Brown.